Honor to God for being here tonight. Thank God for our pastor. Amen. And this opportunity. Thank God for the assistant pastor, Ella Freeman. Thank God for, I'm sorry, I said the assistant pastor, Ella Freeman. The assistant pastor, Elder Fields. Amen. Thank God for Elder Freeman. That's what they started talking about. Thank God for our church mother, Mother Fordham, and Mother Bono, Evangelist World, Evangelist Cruz, who went before me and gave such wonderful word tonight. Thank God for our deacon brothers and each of you in your respective place. Truly, the Lord is worthy to be praised. Amen. And I just thank God for this service tonight because God is a good God. Would you turn to Luke, the 12th chapter. Amen. God is so worthy, saints. God is worthy of the glory, the honor, and the praise. And I wouldn't trade nothing for my journey. Because the Lord knows exactly what we need. Amen. I was just excited and enjoying everything that was said and writing it down. Glory to God. Because God don't want no lukewarm saints coming to Mother Fordham. And God don't want us, God want us to know that it is praying time. And God also want us to know that sin is crouching at our door. Amen. And tonight, I know that the Lord, we can do nothing unless the Lord reveals it unto us. So Luke, the 12th chapter, and the second verse. Luke 12 and 2. Hallelujah. Amen. And it reads, "For there is nothing covered that shall not be revealed, neither hid that shall not be known." Amen. And my subject tonight is not seen, but revealed. There's nothing covered that God don't know. In this time and at this time, and that the Pharisees, they were sneaky and tricky, and we would just say that they were like religious people today, always trying to throw a rock and hide their hand. But God wants us to know that there's nothing that is covered that won't be revealed. God wants us to know that in these times and days and times that we got to know that if we're on the Lord's side, we can't always look at what we perceive to be so, but we got to go in the spirit. Reveal is to make known something hidden, not known, not shown. In theology, it means a supernatural revelation without the aid of natural reason. Something is happening that you can't even explain why it's happening. And seeing is to look at, to be aware of by using the eyes, to perceive objects with the eyes, to be aware of with the mind and to understand. To be revealed deals with the spirit, while just looking deals with the flesh. Your natural ability, how you can see it or not seeing it. I believe that we wouldn't go through as many things as we go through if people would see with the spirit, let it be revealed to them except looking at the eyes. Sometimes I know in your prayer time you have asked why nobody didn't know that I was going through this and why wasn't it revealed to them. Hallelujah. I've been going through and nobody called me, nobody prayed for me, nobody did anything for me, because we are looking at it through our natural eyes instead of being revealed to the spirit. Now you can't see this by just looking. You got to get down on your knees and do something, what we used to call in the old church, kneology. You got to go before God and you got to let the Lord know that, Lord, I'm coming to you all that I know how, and as I intercede for your people, Lord, give me what's going on. Reveal it in the spirit. And as you let the Lord reveal it in the spirit, glory to God, you will not just look at that person when you ask them, how are they doing? about Bunkum and how he was going through with his leg and his knee, and how, hallelujah, he been going through a few days of pain. But that apostle that talked to a Deacon Bunkum, he didn't only just see with his natural eye, but it was revealed in the spirit. So therefore, when it's revealed in the spirit, you don't have to just react, but you can act. You can just say, well, you come on, I'm going to pray for you, but you can exercise your faith. And you can let, hallelujah, the Lord know that you are not just walking in the natural, but you are walking in the spirit. Walking in the spirit means more than just saying I'm walking in the spirit. Walking in the spirit means that you are traveling before God, that you stand in his word, that you are looking to the Lord, hallelujah, by faith, that your spiritual gifts will be exercised. Sometimes, hallelujah, we can't help nobody because we, hallelujah, are having so many isms and schisms. God don't need all that. The devil is doing that by himself. Just like Mother Fulton said, God don't need, hallelujah, hallelujah, nobody to be lukewarm. God don't need nobody that don't care about winning a soul for him. It's so much that people are going through in the world. Don't you know that we don't want to go through in the world because we're supposed to be there to help one another. But what's happening is we're seeing through the natural eye. Hallelujah. You don't know that people are under attack. We're under attack every day. That's why we got to let the Lord use us. That's why we got to depend on the spirit and not on the flesh. Hallelujah. Let me know when my time is up. Peter. Peter, through revelation, revealed who Christ was. While they saying he's this and he's that and one of the prophets, he told them that you are the Christ, the Son of God. And Jesus picked it up and said, flesh and blood didn't reveal that. Some people are looking at you about how you look, but not looking at you about who you are. God, we are not just ordinary, but we are extraordinary, glory to God, because we don't supposed to just walk like anybody else. I don't care what you're going through, you got to learn how not to battle with your fleshly weapons. The weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they're mighty through God for the pulling down of strongholds. What does that mean? That nobody in here, don't get nervous because I got the mic. Nobody in here shouldn't be travailing by yourself. Nobody in here should be dragged through the mud by the devil. Nobody in here could say I'm ready to give up because nobody knows what I'm going through. If you intercede in the spirit, then the spirit will reveal some things to you. That's what's happening. We're too much in the flesh. Looking with the eyes of the spirit. Saints of God, in these days and times that we're going through things that people are going through. People are struggling in their flesh. And they don't know if you let go and let the Lord, hallelujah, have his way in your life. You're not too young for the Lord to use you. Why are you sitting back and feeling sorry for yourself? The God has need of you. God has need of you. God wants to bless you. God wants to heal you of your broken heart. God wants to deliver you and deliver your mind. God wants to put your feet on a solid rock and establish your going. If you would just allow the Lord to use you, you don't have to be crippled. That's just where I said, crouched in sin. Sin don't have to, them have to make it over you. Hallelujah. Because just like an evangelist crew said, it's praying time. And if you pray, and if you seek the Lord's face, then God will do great and mighty things for you. God wants to use some of you to sit in the same spot. You allow him to use you. Hallelujah.
same spot. That's sweet seed sometimes. Don't come into church and sit in the same spot. Don't find yourself doing the same thing. Because it revealed in the spirit that you're crippled. Crippled in what you think. Living for the Lord is all about. It's not about pleasing yourself. It's about pleasing God. And our God, if I'm thinking about it right, is a God that's concerned about people. So if he's concerned about people, he needs each and every one of us to be about our Father's business. I don't care what you got.